Yo, what is going on, everybody? I'm Refo, and today I'm speaking about some basic performance improvements you can do just so you can get a bit more FPS in the new season. So obviously, you know, here on my desktop, you know, you might want a little bit more FPS or a little bit less ping. So I'm going to be showing you some ways that you can do that. So getting straight into it. Okay, so the first thing that you're going to want to do before you do any of this is you're going to want to create a system restore point just to be safe. So obviously to do that, you just type into restore into your search bar. And then search it up, and here you have. So just go through and create your system restore point. All of these changes are very easily reversible anyway, but obviously we're just doing the restore point just to be safe. So just getting straight into the first one, we're gonna search up power plan, and this will pop up, and we're gonna go to power options, and we're gonna obviously have balanced, high performance. Now you could, you know, obviously I would recommend using high performance, but obviously just be aware that this does use more energy, so you know, it could affect your energy bill, that kind of thing. Or if you're on a laptop as well, if you need obviously more, if you obviously you're on a battery as well, you know, just be aware that if you're not plugged in, it's going to use up more power and it's not going to last as long. So the next thing I'm going to be telling you to do is actually, whenever you're playing your games, is to actually go into Task Manager while you're running your game. So let's say, you know, when you're running the game, you're gonna have Fortnite here. And what I want you to do is I just need you to go through and just find anything that you don't need. Like, this is an app here that I don't need. So we're just gonna go through and just anything that we don't need. Although they might not be looking like they're using up big numbers now, if a process in that happens while you're playing your game, it can obviously, you know, affect your performance, you know. So you might have Steam, but all I'm going to say is if you aren't sure on a process, if you're not sure what it does, then don't close it. You know, it only short ones for apps and stuff like that. If you're not sure, you know, what it is completely, don't close it, because, you know, it could obviously affect something. So yeah, just don't close it. And the next thing, still on Task Manager, is actually going into your startup page, and you have your startup page here. So, you know, just going through these, you know, and then finding one that you don't want. So, for example, this here, I actually don't want that on. So, I right-click, and then you press disable. So, that means when the PC loads up now, this will no longer load with the PC, you know, which saves this step. And also, you know, make sure to boot up a little bit quicker. So, you know, anything again here that I'm not sure about, I'm not going to disable it, you know. But anything that I am sure of, I will disable it. Okay, so the next thing I'm speaking about is, like, when you are playing your game, is if you're speaking on Discord, it's potentially trying out your game with Discord closed. Now, I did this, you know, not so long ago. And when I actually play my game, you know, if you just press it and press end task, and I'm just gone. I'm, you know, Discord is there, and it's gone. So that means it's going to take up a little bit less usage, which is obviously very useful. So I would recommend, you know, whatever chat you're using, you know, maybe try and giving game chat a go and just seeing if it works much better. You know, it might not, obviously that's up to you. So the next thing I'm speaking about is going into your apps and actually turning off hardware acceleration. Now obviously this may or may not make a difference for you, but for example here in Spotify we can actually hit here, and we're gonna hit, it'll be in like view, and hardware acceleration is on. If we turn that off, I'll need to restart. And you know, doing that on a few of your apps like Discord, for example, Spotify, you know, what it does, it just uses up less resources on your PC, which is good for your games. So the next thing I'm speaking about is, obviously I'm not actually going to be showing you this because it is a longer process. I will link a video in the description, but it's actually turning on high priority in your Fortnite. Now this is, I'm going to say, if you aren't completely sure about this kind of stuff, I would not recommend it, just because it is a little bit more risky. You're going into registries, and if you mess it up, it can be harder to revert and change back. So you know, I'd only recommend this, you know, if you're really sure that you want to do it. So I'm not going to be showing it. I'm going to be actually linking a video in the description. Obviously, just to mention, obviously, all these things that I'm showing you now, you're obviously trying them at your own risk, you know. So, but obviously, like I say, they all should be safe, but there you are trying them at your own risk. So the last thing for this optimization is actually going to be going into the game files. To do that, you're going to press Windows key plus R, and you're going to press, type in percentage, app data, and percentage again. So obviously then you want to click OK, and it's going to bring up everything here. You're going to press app data, local, and then scroll down to Fortnite game, saved, config, Windows client, game user sec. So obviously, you need to here click properties, just check that you've got your read only unticked, which is going to be important. And you want to go into here and go through and change a few settings, which I'm going to be showing you. So the first setting is show grass. Make sure that that is set to false. So if you obviously aren't sure about how to find any of these, you actually go to edit and you click find. And for example, I could type in grass and I want to press down and then it will show me like where it is, you know, just there. So, or, you know, I could put anything else and it'll find it for me. So then I would recommend, obviously, you know, so once you've done show grass, that's a good one to disable, is actually scrolling all the way to the bottom and finding these settings here. So the two ones that you get all access to, these ones in game view distance, you know, you can do that in game. But foliage quality and shading quality are actually set quite high by default, and you can turn these down. So put those on to zero, and then you want to close this, you want to make sure you save it, and then properties, and then hit read only, apply, and you're done. If your game is running exceptionally slow, I would actually recommend heading over to the Epic Games launcher, and something good to do is to actually verify your game files. It is always good to do. So to do that, you obviously want to come into your library, and then you want to press the three little dots here and then hit verify, and that will start a process, you know, which will take, you know, it shouldn't take too long. It should be a process, and then you obviously, that will make sure all the game files are looking good. So that is all the basic optimizations I provide. Like I say, I haven't gone too in depth, partly, you know, this is because these are like safe optimizations. You know, I didn't want to go anything too far. If this video did help you out and improve your FPS, please consider dropping a like. And if you do want to see more tips and tricks videos, please consider subscribing to the channel. You have been awesome, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.